Microsoft has quietly integrated a micro model called MU into the new Copilot Plus PCs, and honestly, it's astonishing how much horsepower they've packed into just 330 million parameters. Unlike most models that chew through your request piece by piece, MU works smarter. It dissects your question once, holds the core meaning in memory, and then constructs its response from that, without wasting time rereading the whole thing. Thanks to this clever setup, and because it runs directly on a specialized chip called the Neural Processing Unit, or NPU, it replies much faster. We're talking almost twice as quick for that crucial first word, and nearly five times faster overall compared to similar models. So, when you type something like dim the keyboard backlight after 5 minutes into your settings, it responds instantly. No cloud, no frustrating delay. To keep things incredibly efficient, the team designed MU to share certain pieces of its internal structure, and they expertly divided the workload so the NPU can handle multiple tasks simultaneously without breaking a sweat. They also added advanced techniques to help it track longer conversations, preventing confusion while using less memory for training. But they didn't just feed it random internet data. They started with high-quality educational material, then distilled knowledge from much larger, more powerful models. This allowed MU to be incredibly smart without needing to be enormous. And understanding language isn't enough. They needed MU to comprehend how to actually change Windows settings. So they trained it with over 3.5 million examples, covering everything from screen brightness to privacy options. They even included variations, typos, and all sorts of real-world phrasing to ensure it could handle messy inputs. After fine-tuning, MU performed almost as well as much larger models, yet remained lightweight and incredibly fast. With some additional optimization, they got it down to run on local chips with no slowdown, outputting more than 200 words per second on devices like the Surface Laptop 7. The end result? When you ask it something complex, it replies in under half a second. And for quick one-word searches, it still intelligently uses regular search under the hood, so you don't get weird guesses. Even better, if you have two monitors and ask it to adjust brightness, it'll smartly ask which one you mean, ensuring it doesn't just adjust both like a blunt tool. Now, swinging from Windows to music, Google's Magenta team just dropped Magenta Real-Time, Magenta RT for short. In the generative audio scene, this is a genuine left hook. This model is open weight under Apache 2.0, living on GitHub and Hugging Face, and clocks in at a hefty 800 million parameters. But here's the kicker. It turns out 2 seconds of 48K audio stereo in about 1.25 seconds on a free-tier Colab TPU. That forward real-time factor of roughly 0.625 means you can actually jam live, feed it style prompts mid-performance, and never wait for a giant batch render. Under the hood, the pipeline might look familiar if you've peeked at Music LM or Music FX, except Magenta RT rolls everything into a streamer. Audio is broken into discrete codec tokens, and each segment is conditioned on a running 10-second history, plus your text, or even a tiny audio clip mapped through a joint embedding called Music Coco. That hybrid of Mulan and Coco lets a phrase like lo-fi house groove with warm roads blend seamlessly with a 4-bar guitar lick you just recorded. And the model keeps the vibe consistent as new chunks roll in. Training used around 190,000 hours of instrumental stock tracks, all passed through a hierarchical neural codec so fidelity stays crisp, while token sequences remain short. The transformer itself is optimized for chunk streaming. Every 2-second window is generated with overlapping boundaries to avoid clicks, and XLA compilation plus heavy cache reuse keeps device memory from thrashing. Google claims you can morph genres or instruments in the middle of a bar, go from synthwave to bossa nova piano without dropping tempo, and because the repo is self-hostable, no one's locking you into an API bill or throttled rate limits. They're already hinting at on-device inference pathways and personal fine-tunes, so DJs or game devs can bake in their own sonic fingerprints. Compared with diffusion approaches like Refusion or big auto-regressive beasts like OpenAI's Jukebox, Magenta RT's low latency is the breakthrough. You're steering the ship in real time instead of waiting minutes for a WAV file to dump. While we're talking local agents, a tiny startup called Similar wants to reinvent web browse on the Mac, ditching the usual cloud-hosted puppetry. Similar spins up a fully sandboxed webkit, window right on your desktop and shadows every click you make. The whole dance stays on device, so every cookie, login token, and autofill scrap lives on your SSD instead of zipping off to some distant data center. The whole point is shared control. The agent gets to drive, but you never lose the wheel. If it tries to slam the buy button too soon or misreads a captcha, you just nudge it aside with the trackpad, override a form, or steer to a different tab. No forced handoff dialogue, no lag, no anxious wait while a remote model replays the page DOM. The founders cut their teeth on multi-agent systems at DeepMind, so they built the open-source S2 framework under similar. Think of it like a modular pit crew. A high-level planner sketches. The goal, a vision layer reads live pixels to spot buttons, smaller sub-agents handle scrolling or text entry, and a short-term memory thread keeps track of what was clicked 2 minutes ago. That architecture is why the thing posted an astonishing 90.05% completion score on the messy RealSight Web Voyager benchmark and still edged out OpenAI and Anthropic on O-World and Android World, where half the tasks involve pop-ups, infinite scroll, and badly labeled inputs. The kind of stuff you'd expect to trip any bot. Early adopters say it's already saving them from the grinding stuff. One user had it juggle a 3-store grocery run for a weekend cookout, dumping sriracha into Instacart, bio buns into Amazon Fresh, and a specialty cake into a local bakery's commerce portal, all while popping up a quick sound good confirmation before each checkout. Another kept it running in the pile. Background to pull tracking numbers from 5 different e-commerce sites, scrape every in-transit status, and drop a tidy summary into Notion. There's even a clip of a journalist letting similar harvest a dozen research articles, boil them down to tidy abstracts, and then handing control back so she could cherry-pick quotes. Because everything's local, the agent logs into those paywalled sites with the same keychain credentials you'd use in Safari. Nothing leaks outward, nothing's stored off-device, and if you hit Wi-Fi turbulence on a train, the workflow doesn't collapse. That blend of autonomy plus instant override is the big philosophical swing. The team doesn't think people will trust fully hands-free browsers for years, so similar acts more like a diligent coworker who gladly pushes the mail cart but still taps you when a signature is required. And yeah, speaking of trust, OpenAI managed to stumble into a trademark tangle that forced a vanishing act. Remember the buzzy partnership with ex-Apple design legend Jony Ive? They announced a $6.5 billion acquisition of his hardware shop called I.O., planning ultra-minimal AI devices. Well, a hearing aid startup called IYO sued over the almost identical name, and a court slapped a takedown order on OpenAI's promo material. Overnight, the blog post and slick 9-minute video of Ive chatting with Sam Altman disappeared from OpenAI.com, though you can still find the clip floating on YouTube. OpenAI's spokesperson, Kayla Wood, says the deal itself is totally intact. They just have to scrub the branding until lawyers sort it out. Ive, who walked away from Apple back in 2019 after sketching icons like the iPhone, Apple Watch, and AirPods, sounded giddy in the video. He told Altman that everything he'd learned in 30 years led to this moment. Altman, meanwhile, flashed a prototype and called it the coolest piece of technology that the world will have ever seen. Details are scarce, but insiders keep describing an unobtrusive desktop companion that stays aware of your environment and fits naturally alongside a MacBook Pro and iPhone. The release isn't expected until next year, yet the legal snag shows how even giants can trip over trademarks when hardware ambitions meet the messy real world. All right, that's the scoop for today. If you're tinkering with any of these, let me know how they fit into your stack. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.